Hi, my name's Tasia, and I'm here to talk to you today a little bit about some of the cool experiments that you can do at home with Earth Observatory for Kids. If you go to earthobservatory.nasa.gov/eokids, you can find a bunch of articles and activities geared for kids ages 9 to 14. One of the activities that we're going to try today with you is our cloud in a bottle activity. You can find this one in our Clouds or Snow, a Satellite Mystery issue. In that issue, you'll find out how NASA uses satellites to determine differences between clouds and snow, because from above, they look white, and we may not know. But using specific sensors and technology, NASA is able to figure out a lot of different things about the Earth below and find out exactly what types of clouds are there in our sky. So today we are going to do an activity where we make a cloud in a bottle. You need very simple ingredients. First, an empty 2-liter bottle. This one's empty. Just a little bit of rubbing alcohol. And a bicycle pump with a rubber stopper with a hole in the bottom that goes all the way through. Or you can also use a pin for a basketball or soccer ball or any type of ball that you would use as the pin to blow it up. If you do that, take a cork. If you put it in the microwave for about 15 seconds, it'll expand a little bit and actually fill the hole in your 2-liter bottle. And then you can take the pin and push it through all the way. And then you'll be able to use that just like this rubber stopper. So right now we are going to go ahead and make that cloud in a bottle. So the first thing I do is I add a little bit of rubbing alcohol, swish it around, swish, 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 coat the outside of my bottle, and then I take the rubber stopper on my pump and make a really tight seal. We want to make sure that it's really in there because it's going to want to fly out otherwise. This next step is probably important if you're going to do this by yourself, eye protection. If you have a friend who's willing to sit and do it with you, find a parent or somebody else that can really tightly hold that cork or rubber stopper inside your 2-liter bottle. Otherwise, it could fly off and hurt someone. So be careful. So I'm going to use eye protection. So here we go. First thing, I'm going to make sure I hold it nice and tight. I'm a professional, so I'm sure I can do this pretty well. So we're going to pump up our bottle with our bicycle pump. Here we go. And oh, before I start, I forgot to show you. See, it's really squishy right now. When I add all that air in there, it's not going to be squishy anymore. So let's see what happens. All right, I'm pumping it up. Here we go. All right, let's see. Should we see how squishy it is now? Ooh, look at that. I can barely squish it. All right, I might add just a couple more. Oh, it's getting harder to pump. This is me getting my workout today. All right, you guys ready? So I'm going to let the air that we just added to this bottle, and inside the bottle, we created a bunch of air pressure because we added a bunch of air and it can't leave, right? There's nowhere for it to go. It's stuck inside this bottle. It's trapped underneath this cork. But when I let it go, all that pressure is going to escape. And when the pressure inside the bottle decreases, the temperature is also going to decrease. So it's going to get colder in there. And when it gets colder, the water molecules in our air condense. And that is how clouds form. Condensed just means that they get closer together. So we are going to get our water molecules in our clouds or in our air closer together and form a cloud. You guys ready? So since it's NASA, we're going to count down from 3, 3, 2, 1. And there you have it. Cloud in a bottle. Thanks for joining. You can download any other issues and activities here at earthobservatory.nasa.gov/eokids. Have a great day.